Hey there everyone, Hitesh here and welcome to another video. This video is a precise guide of a roadmap of what to learn, what to skip among the data structure. First, just understand this one very, very important thing that just because we say data structures and algorithm in just one sentence, they are not the same. There should be a pinpoint precise guide for learning data structure and for algorithm. This one is for data structure. This guide will help you to understand and pinpoint all the topics that you should learn in the very first go and have a solid foundation of what to learn and what to skip. Let's go ahead and get started. And by the way, this video is sponsored by Geeks for Geeks. Geeks for Geeks is hosting a Geeks Premier League, which is a fun contest in which you can write your articles, and the first prize is actually MacBook Pro. I'll come back onto this in a minute, but first, let's go ahead and focus back onto the topic of how to learn data structures. Now, learning the data structure is not that difficult, especially if you have a guide that what should I learn and what should I skip. Now, obviously, you're going to have an expertise in some of these data structure more compared to others, because we all try to learn and pretend that we know about it a lot, but in the reality, you will have great understanding of that in the production. For example, people who are working in Swiggy and Zomato, they are dealing with the graphs so much more compared to other engineers, so they will have much more experience in that. So it depends on what domain you are going to work. Now let's go ahead and get started with the precise topics on what you should learn and what you can skip. Starting with data structure number zero, which is array. Now this is not an option. This is not an exception. You need to know your array to the best. You should be able to perform all the CRUD operations on the array. You should be able to perform all the search operation in the array, as well as you should know that at what point array is good and at what point array is not so good. And that's it. That's all you need to know. No matter what your language is, you just need to master your arrays. No exception in that. Now, one more thing I would like to add here that at this point, you just want to master your array. Bubble sort and all of that, these are algorithms. You don't want to mix them up right here. You're now focusing on data structure first. Algorithms will come up later. Once you are done with your array, the next data structure you want to master is linked list. Now, linked list is considered as, oh, it's too big, it's too heavy. No, it is not. It's just a simple, very simple data structure. Some of these languages provide it out of the box, some don't. So you can just create class and provide some of the rules that this is how my data structure is going to work. There is nothing more than that in the linked list. You should be focused on just three things in the linked list: the search, the insertion, and the deletion. That's it. That's all we care in the very first go. Now, obviously, in the very first go of learning the data structure, you should also focus on singular, doubly linked list, and the circular as well. But don't go into too much of the rabbit hole. You just want to know that what are the rules of defining these, and that's it. That's all you want to do. Now, once you're done with that, then comes is the stack. The reason why I moved the stack here, because it's so much easy to learn. After you have done and messed around with the linked list, you need some easier topic. So that's where the stack comes in. Stack is the easiest one to learn out of all of them. Last in, first in, last out, that's majorly it. And just the pop and the push, that's basically it. There is nothing too much of the dynamic things that are happening around. It's a really simple one. That's what I want to say. Now, just because it's the simple one, don't underestimate that. It is so much of importance. And in fact, a lot of your languages like JavaScript and a whole lot of other languages also use this internally. And you'll be using them quite a lot. So don't underestimate it, but yes, it's comparatively easy to learn. Next, just after the stack, you want to learn about the queues. And queues, this is where I love the things. Queues you'll be using a lot. And in case you are planning to use AWS or some video processing or something, you cannot avoid queues. There are so many of the out-of-the-box queues that are given to you, like RabbitMQ and all of them. They are somewhat implementation of this queue data structure. A video goes into the AWS infrastructure, you process it, probably add some watermark onto that and put that into the folder. This all is happening via the queue. While learning the queues, you don't want to go into the rabbit hole of multi-threading and how it works. Basic idea obviously is good, but you just want to learn about how to enqueue or dequeue, or some call it as deck, whatever you want to say that, but that's all you want to first focus. Now, before we move into the segment of future data structures, I would like to bring in Geeks for Geeks as a sponsor here. Now, Geeks for Geeks is hosting a Geeks Premier League, which is a very fun contest. In case you have ever wondered that how these articles come around, is there a team in the Geeks for Geeks or people write that? It's kind of a mix of both. Geeks for Geeks allow this opportunity for guys like you and me to share their experience or their expertise in the form of articles. And now in this Geeks Premier League, they are offering some prizes, some cash rewards and a whole lot of other things as well. The first prize is MacBook, but my eye is on that smart band because I exercise a lot and there's a lot of bands to give away. So my eyes is actually on that. But again, I would highly recommend that whatever the skills you have, whatever the knowledge you have, go to the link which is in the description. If you can write some articles or share some thoughts on that or share some expertise, go ahead, write that and maybe just give it a try. Maybe the MacBook is for you. So go ahead, check out link in the description section, write some articles, and if you win, let me know. Now moving into the segment of hash tables. Now hash table is one of those data structure which is at first glance it looks easy, but it's not that easy. You might want to focus a bit more on that. Now hash maps are majorly used in directly pinpointing of where the value is stored. These are key value pairs. And in every language they are known with slightly different names, but usually it's hash map, hash table, something like that. Now they are used heavily in the databases indexing, and you'll be solving a whole lot of competitive programming problems using this hash set or hash table or hash map, whatever you want to say that. But yes, this is the next data structure you want to explore. Again, don't go too much into the algorithm rabbit hole yet. You just want to master how it looks like, how can I access some elements, how can I remove some element or something like that. Now next that comes up is the monster of the data structure, which is trees. And this is where majority of the people get confused about. Now here's my personal recommendation of how to get started and learn about trees. Just learn about the binary search tree. That is it. You might want to learn about what is parent node, left child, right child, and how to access them, how to traverse just only on the left side, how to traverse on just on the right side, how to traverse on the breadth side, how to traverse onto the length side. You want to really master all of that. One of the common mistakes that people does is before truly understanding the binary search tree, they want to get into fancy trees like red, black tree and all of them. But what you don't know is majority of them are actually coming up from this binary search tree. They are somewhere, some modified version of them. So it is my personal recommendation that you should not go into 10 different types or red, black tree or AVL trees and all of them. That is going to come up in the second round of your learning journey of data structure. But first, you should be absolutely a master of binary search tree, period. Now after that, come up is the heap. Now if you have focused a lot on the binary search tree, the heap is going to take you just probably an hour at a max. That's the power of learning the binary search tree. There's also a TREEPS. I'm pretty sure you don't want to go too much in depth. If you are doing any masters of wireless expertise, which I was doing, there you use TREEPS a lot, but in general, I haven't seen much of them. And once you are done with that, finally, you are going to take down the graphs. Now, graphs can be as complicated as you want them, but you want to focus just on the basics of that. How the graph works, what are the vertices, indexes, and nodes. You also want to learn about what are directed graphs, non-directed graphs, cyclic graphs, acyclic graphs, just the basic theory of them and just the basic operation on them. Now, surely graph, you can spend months and maybe years to learn about them, but what I believe truly is that as you do a bit more of the competitive programming, you learn a lot more about the graph. That is much more easier way of learning the graphs. Now, on top of that, I'm super happy that now we have companies right here in India that you don't have to apply for Google's and go into the Google Maps division to absolutely master graph. But now we have companies like Ola, we have Uber, we have Zomato, Swiggy, and a whole lot of them that are not just solving the graph problem, but they are solving graph problem which are on steroids. And again, that is it. That is all you want to learn in the very first go of your learning journey of data structure. Now, surely this journey is going to get a lot of revisions, a lot of new data structures you might want to learn after that, but these are the must-have basics that everyone should have. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and again, a big thanks to Geeks for Geeks for sponsoring this video. Check out their link in description and also write some articles for them and say thanks that they have sponsored this video. And again, if you win some of the prizes, do let me know on my Instagram as well.